Hello, you beautiful people. Saints here. And this evening I'm going to be playing The Expanse, a Telltale series. This is the first ever Telltale game I've ever played, so yeah, it should be a new experience for me. But anyways, yeah, let's press any button to continue, eh? Accessibility settings, we'll go with that. How do I set volume and stuff like that? Anyways, yeah, let's just get into it. So Drummer's not about to listen.
No!
Eight hours earlier.
Let's celebrate.
What are we celebrating?
Our last mission.
I've heard that before.
This is the one. By the end of the day, all of us are going to be fucking rich, but mostly you and me.
It's another wreck.
It's not just any wreck. The UNN Urshanabi. Dropped off the map less than a week ago. No distress call. Those UNN pricks never come out this far unless they're carrying something special.
Aren't you one of those UNN pricks?
Easy. If I'm still one of those UNN pricks, then you're still an OPA traitor with Anderson Dawes' bounty on your head. But the past is the past.
The past is the past.
The past is the past.
Why didn't you take it? The bounty.
I knew you were worth more. Anybody who could piss off someone that dangerous must be pretty fucking valuable.
I knew you were worth more. Anyone could piss off Dawes. Yeah, go on.
Anderson Dawes is a gangster and a killer. It's not hard to piss off a man like that.
Well, his loss is my gain.
Just want to make sure you're not having second thoughts about our deal.
No, come on. We're equal partners. We pay the crew, the costs, and the overhead. The rest is 50-50. You and me. We've got a good thing going here. Nobody fucks with you, which means nobody fucks with me. And hell, if this score is what I think it could be, you've got the deal of the century. Now drink.
Go on, why not? Bottoms up. I'll drink the scotch.
Yam sang, or whatever the fuck you people say.
Close enough.
Thank you.
Time to rally the crew for Cox's latest, last mission. I should start by briefing Khan.
Hold up. Settings. Audio. Gonna turn the massive volume down a little bit. There we go. And effects. Music. Apply. See how that goes. I'll go this way. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, God. Oh, I've got to change that. Why can't it let me do this beforehand? Gameplay. Invert Y. Apply. I was trying to do this before stream, but no, I weren't allowed.
Khan, new orders from the captain.
I know. He already sent me the coordinates.
Captain thinks that this could be
last score we'll ever need. Hall of a century. I got the pep talk from him.
What's our ETA?
It depends.
On what?
On how long you plan to waste my time.
Ooh. Feisty.
Oh dear. I made the lackey upset. Forgive me.
Wow, put the claws away.
Fashang Fong, you old bat. I'll break through to you eventually.
You wanna braid somebody's hair? Go find Maya. I'm busy.
I like Khan.
We're nearly there. The debris field is massive. It'll take me a minute to navigate. Somebody blew that ship to hell and back.
I should check the command console for more information on the Urshanabi. She's been chewing on that same cigar for weeks. Wouldn't want to do a high G burn in one of these. It's bad enough with the juice and the cushy chair.
Sorry about this. Voices down too.
Wouldn't want to do a high G burn in one of these.
Bloody hell.
It's bad enough with the juice and the cushy chair.
Still pretty loud. That's the volume as well. There we go. We'll try that.
As the XO, it's my job to make sure the ship and its crew are in order. I keep a log on the ship and on our scavenge missions.
Brief version, that was the default one.
Haven't had to shoot much, but we keep the PDCs fully stocked.
Sounds
just in case.
It's not too bad. It's better.
Time to find the rest of the crew. Arlen said he put all this away. What was it, 3 days ago? Lazy Gemming. Ship's diagnostics always come back good. The Artemis isn't much to look at, but she's built to last. Of course, Cox needs to get his beauty rest before he gets back to work, doing absolutely nothing.
So Virgil's in the crew deck, eh?
Maya has a plan for this meditation session. She's going to bring her makeup kit and wait until Virgil gets into a deep trance. Then go to town on him. I may have to watch. Virgil. Virgil.
Exo drummer.
Usually medics only know enough to plug that thing in and rig up the morphine dispenser.
Well, I took a course in autodoc repair during my residency. Useful for work outside the medical system. It's been giving me abnormal readings since Ceres, but I finally know why. The laser crystal's badly occluded.
That sounds serious. Can we replace it?
We can, and should. Normally I wouldn't recommend it. I could always open people up the old-fashioned way. But the twins get into more mishaps than a normal crew. A high-quality gem would ensure that I'm ready for their next disaster. I assume you didn't come here to talk about crystals.
We have a new target.
What is it this time, El Dorado? The Fountain of Youth? Let me guess. The Falcon Horde of Venus?
Ah.
The UNN Urshanabi. Cap believes there's something valuable on board. Something special.
Something special.
Do we want to invite that kind of attention?
We'll be fine. In and out. No games.
I'll monitor any data you send back, and I'll be here to patch anyone up, should it come to that.
When Cox recruited me, a big selling point was the med bay and the medic. Not something you see on most scavenging ships. Should I be concerned that our medic thinks we need this many prosthetics? Does he know something I don't?
Maybe he does.
No one on this ship likes to talk about their past, but Virgil is a real mystery. Only Cox knows his deal, and he's not saying. We never have enough supplies, but Virgil always seems to make do. Any other medic, and I'd assume he spent a day napping in this, but not this medic. Where do I look for a replacement crystal?
Aside from medical, high-end navigation or communication systems use them as well.
Okay.
What's your excuse this time? You not get enough sleep? You need some aqua caca, huh?
Ow! Just let me go. It just fell, okay?
What I tell you? Tinsha, you stupid prick! Quit fucking up!
Boss man, make him stop!
Shut it, Okaka!
Carry on. I'm enjoying the show.
Si passion wala, even Exo agrees.
Okay, okay. For the god, brother.
We got a job, Baradnos. Listen up.
Nah. Fuck that. I'm tired of rooting around in the dumpster for that Inya.
Cox promised us a real payday. He said, give me 3 months and you never have to work again. He said...
He said, this the next job. And he the boss man.
Just like Ceres. Bossing everyone around. Only this time no dolls to keep you on the leash, yeah?
Punch him. Boom. Oh, sock to the face.
On the ship, I'm the Exo.
Yeah, that's it. Stamp your authority down.
Shit. I was only fucking with you, Copang. Come on, Baratna.
So far, none of the biomass that's gone through this recycler has been a crew member. I consider that a win.
Yeah. Guess so.
Supplies are always tight on long jobs, but we're running low on even the basics now. Nothing like fresh herbs and spices to go with dry kibble. Arlen is right that Rayan can't keep his shit from breaking. It only makes my job harder.
Hey, kibble.
Food in the belt is never fancy. But my stomach still turns when I look at this mush.
Looks tasty.
ETA, 5 minutes, drummer.
Will do, boss man. Headed back to my room to suit up now. I got a lot closer to a captain's chair than I would have expected. And a lot further away from anything else.
I imagine we're playing as belters then. Oh, data cube.
Those gave me everything. A job, a purpose, a community. Until he took it all away. Even with everything he's done to me, I would never turn Dawes into UN enforcers. Took every yen I had to get off Ceres without Dawes or Star Helix noticing. Never had time for dating on Ceres. Now I've got plenty of time and no one to date. A little token of my childhood on Ceres. Each time it gets another crack, it reminds me of that shit heap even more.
Nice. Let's suit up then.
Where are you going to go, Kamina? Huh?
Anywhere but here. With anyone but you.
Are you talking to
me? Hate me all you want. You are many things, Beltaloda, but you are not a traitor. You love your belt. And right now, belt is me.
Yeah, that belts us.
I'm busy. You're late. Quit tinkering and get your helmet. We're about to push off. Fucking make me. Typical Martian, with a mouth that only knows how to kiss ass and spew caca. I already beat Arlen.
Hey, Nobish. How's it going? You alright, yeah? Patient. Hugs right back at ya.
I should put you in the brig for this. You'd have to catch me first.
Cutting thrust. Prepare to enter float in 3, 2...
Bit of sexual tension there.
Come on. Let me hear it. You got me. Fuck yes. Finally! You were kicking my ass for a minute. I thought you had me again. That was a good move. Kind of a cheap shot, though.
If it was a cheap shot, I would have smashed your brittle belter bones against the ceiling.
Don't believe everything they taught you in the Martian Navy. My bones are just as strong as yours.
I didn't believe a single thing they taught me at that fascist brainwash factory. That's why I'm here with you, brittle bitches.
Arlen and Rayan have begun breaching the airlock off the bridge. Once we're in, we're going
Holy shit! Io! Usually Io is covered up by these dust streams that fire off from its poles after volcanic activity. But it's clear as day.
It's hard for me to look at these moons without thinking about the Earther research colonies exploiting all the resources on them and giving nothing to the belt.
That's fucked up.
I usually only look for what could kill me out here. But it's nice getting to see it through your eyes. Even if they're the eyes of an inner who doesn't know her ass from her oxygen valve.
You mean an inner who pile-drived your ass into a ceiling, right?
She's milking that for all it's worth, isn't she?
Let's head out. Just remember to...
Woohoo!
Nice shot.
As I was saying, remember to keep your weight back when you land.
Still, not bad for an inner who's barely been in the belt for a month, eh?
Reminds me when Rayana and I were learning to spacewalk. One time, he crashed right into the hull and shit his back suit.
Shut it! Quiet! Oh.
Airlock is open, Exo.
Good. Let's see what we have in here.
One sec. All right. I need to turn the volume down again. It's really loud in my headphones. All right. This should hopefully be the last time.
Fucking table scraps.
Sound a little better. It's usually when drummer speaks, it's the loudest, though. Oh, wow.
Yo, Bharatna. She's crazy.
Yes, indeed. Bonk.
Just breathe. Keep your head down. It's okay.
Now say puke in your suit, okay? That you won't choke to death on your own sick.
All lined up in a row there. Jeez. So a lot of heads.
Enough. Whoever put out this welcome gift for us is long gone, and they left behind a big-ass ship that must have some valuables still on it. So get scavenging!
You all have your orders.
Yeah, they definitely lost their heads.
So we can get back home.
I'm gonna One more time. Alright, we'll go with that. Just have a little explore around, seeing what's what, seeing what's what here.
I've got an intact QPU here.
Nice find.
Oh, all right, okay.
Fuel, oxygen, scrap metal, wiring. If we can use it or sell it, it goes in here. Pirates tore this place apart, but pirates aren't scavengers.
Lift off. Cool.
Fuel, oxygen, scrap metal, wiring. If we can use it or sell it, it goes in here.
Oh, we're going in. We've already been here. We're upside down anyway, I just remembered that. Let's go in there. No? Can't look at that.
Looks like a fabricator of some kind. Maybe for material printing? Do we...
Yes! Gimme, gimme!
Oh, cutscene.
Okay. Time to scavenge.
Drummer, looks like the officer's section is still intact. Go check it out.
on it.
You know the military. The brass always hoards the best shit.
Let's hope so.
Yeah, let's go over here then. Water recycler.
Clean palladium in this recycler.
Good pull, drummer. UNN officers always keep a backup water recycler for themselves.
You are a UNN officer. Do you have a backup recycler for yourself?
Of course not. I drink the same cloudy sludge as the rest of you.
Mm-hmm.
Commanders, this is Private Takabe. The pirates have asked me to report the following. All crew members, except for those barricaded in the officers' quarters, have been killed or captured. The pirates do not wish to kill anyone else. If you open the gate now and allow them to complete their search, no more lives will be lost. And if you do not comply, oh God, please don't.
That's what happens, I guess. Jeez. Well.
Arlen and Rayan's experience hauling minerals on Vesta has been a big help, even when they annoyed the hell out of me.
What we got in here?
Not a lot of particulates in the air filter. Virgil, how long do you think the bodies have been like this? A couple of days?
That's my assumption, after analyzing the footage of the heads and the remnants of the precipitating battle.
What can you tell me about the heads, medically speaking?
From the uniformity of the incisions, it seems clear they were done post-mortem. Very difficult to be precise if the victim is fighting back.
Last time Khan smoked a cigar on the ship, Maya had to spend half the day cleaning out the air filter.
It's in the other room. Let's have a look. Oh, la. Yeah, I'm on my way.
Hey, Khan. You've been flying a long time. Ever seen anything like this before?
Nah. When it comes to pirates, nothing surprises me. They're all monsters.
You've seen the damage they did. What do you think they were after?
Could be anything. Question is, whether they found it or not.
Skinnies. Bigoted asshole. He still didn't deserve to die like this.